Ever since the announcement of Sonic Unleashed, we've seen this trend of showing a Sonic game via CG trailer, and later down the line, we'll eventually see gameplay. To be exact, Sonic Unleashed, Sonic Colors, Sonic Generations, Sonic Forces, Team Sonic Racing, and now with Sonic Frontiers, were and are deploying this tactic. At first, no one seemed to care that this tactic was being deployed, but now this tactic has been seen in scrutiny, especially in the cases of the more recent Sonic games. To which, I have to ask the question, has this tactic been effective, or has it created more trouble than usual? I'm going to tackle this topic by assessing why this worked in the past, why it's no longer seen as good, and what changed. Plus, I'll give my answers to the question of if the marketing strategy is effective. And finally, I'll give my approach to marketing Sonic Frontiers. So, let's dive right in. So like I said, the first game to deploy this tactic was Sonic Unleashed. This was during a time when the Sonic brand was heavily damaged, thanks to the release of Sonic 06, as that seemed to be the reason why this was the main marketing strategy for Unleashed. Get people to pay attention to the game by showing something of mystery. And it worked. Sort of. Even though Unleashed was not received well critically, the game was one of the highest selling games for Sega that year. And there's also another reason why I think it worked, and primarily it has to do with the length of marketing. You see, Sega unveiled Sonic Unleashed the same year as the release of the game, so meaning they had a short amount of time to go out and market the game. And for the most part, Sega did a good job of marketing the game in a short amount of time. And the same thing could be said about both Colors and Generations, as both games were also unveiled during the same time of release, meaning they will unveil information in a short amount of time. So I can see why the CG trailer first wasn't a bad idea initially, because shortly after, people were going to get bombarded with information to keep their interest. And also there's also another reason, but we'll save that for later. Fast forward now with the releases of both Forces and Team Sonic Racing, the same tactic was used for both games, and currently now with Frontiers. Though unfortunately the only game to garner any kind of positive interest from this marketing tactic was Forces. There's a reason behind this, but we'll once again save that for later. It kind of ties into my third point. Though, I think the main reason why these games are just having a hard time to get any kind of positive hype is primarily due to length of marketing. As you see, all three games were unveiled a year before release. And surely you'd think more time means more time to go out and market the game to maintain interest, but that's not entirely the case right there. When Sonic Forces was unveiled back in July of 2016, we didn't get any kind of information about that game until March of next year. That's quite some time right there. Also, any interview from Takashi Iizuka or the producers on these games were intentionally fake. Any information on this game was left fake intentionally of what they were planning to do with the game going forward. So, it kind of makes sense to why the marketing tactic wasn't really working that well for Sonic Forces. And going into Team Sonic Racing, this was a little bit of an outlier, because Team Sonic Racing was supposed to release the same year as unveiled, but of course the game got delayed. Though, like Sonic Forces, Sega didn't really use that extra time to go out and promote the game. We literally saw gaps between gameplay trailers. Kinda knows the trend right here? Just long gaps of information dumps on the game. Yeah, it's kind of an unfortunate thing right here, and it's basically happening right now with Sonic Frontiers. When we saw Sonic Frontiers back in that Sonic Central stream in May, we literally just got a CG trailer with no title. And we literally didn't get barely any information until Game Awards of 2021, where we finally saw something of the game, though it wasn't even gameplay, it was just in-game footage of the game. So yeah, you can kind of see why this marketing strategy isn't working for these games. Due to these long gaps of information and the people who are making these games just being straight off vague about these games. But I did say that the only game to garner any kind of interest was Sonic Forces. Why is that? Well, let's get into my next point. So this one point right here, I think is the ultimate reason to why the current marketing strategy isn't working. And that is trust within Sonic Team. Back during the late 2000s, despite the bad PR from Sonic 06, there were still a majority of Sonic fans who still had trust within Sonic Team. Sure, everyone else in the gaming realm saw Sonic as a laughingstock, but Sonic fans were still willing to support Sonic despite this major low. Unleashed was seen as a good game, and the same goes for both Colors and Generations, so when Forces was announced, that trust that fans had with Sonic Team was still there. But of course, Forces ended up being a massive disappointment, to which I believe destroyed any trust within Sonic Team, and just the Sonic franchise in general. So, It made sense when Team Sonic Racing deployed the same tactic. There were people that instantly noticed the similar marketing to Forces, meaning that people were more cautious about that game when it announced there was no gameplay footage, even though it was being developed by a different developer. Plus, it didn't help matters the game was delayed a month before the original release, with people talking about how the game was never intended to release during that time, making all these theories and such. So, it should come as no surprise when Frontiers was announced with a CG trailer, large number of Sonic fans pointed this out in a negative way, comparing this to games like Forces and Team Sonic Racing, and that's all due to trust within Sonic Team. And also a little side note, it should be obvious that a marketing tactic isn't working if people go off their way to rely on leaks and rumors just to get any kind of information.
So, to answer the question, has this tactic been effective?
The answer is yes and no.
So let me explain. Back then, thanks to the trust of fans and the effective use of time, the marketing tactic of CG trailers was able to work its magic to generate buzz and hype for the game. But now, where a Sonic game is unveiled a year in advance with large gaps between information and trust within the developers is at an all-time low, it makes sense to why people are very indifferent to this tactic. And it's primarily due to the fact that developers haven't done a great job at telling their consumers that they should trust them again. It's rather disappointing. If you want my take of how they should handle marketing for Sonic Frontiers, the answer is simple. Be more upfront with the game. Even though you still have nothing to show, just giving concrete details of how the game is going to be like is more than enough to let people's minds go wild. For example, before The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild was released, series producer Eiji Aonuma would go on length about the intentions for the next Zelda game, the direction the game will take, and how they want the progression to work. And that information alone was enough for fans, because they were very much excited of this new direction Zelda was going to take. Another example is happening right now with Dragon Quest. The next mainline game, Dragon Quest XII, we've only seen a logo for, but we know exactly the direction the team is going to take with that game. Series creator Yuji Horii made the intentions clear that Dragon Quest XII will go in a different route both in tone and gameplay. So just having simple statements for fans of these franchises are more than enough to get them hyped for a game. You shouldn't be vague on details, you should be more upfront and clear about the main direction you're taking the game to. And I personally think Takashi Iizuka and the devs of Sonic Team can learn from this. It can help rebuild trust between them and the fans. So that's just my take on this whole marketing strategy. A strategy that only works when there is trust, and how effective you are in promoting the game. So comment down below on how you think about this marketing strategy. I would like to hear them. And also make sure you give this video a like as well. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Take care.